on Saturday morning and we leave Stocking Island. This guy out here just parked in the middle of the channel. Seems a little unnecessary. We are managing to sail, but it is pitifully slowly. We're managing a bit less than 3 knots. Less than 10 knots of wind. And Costa 6 is coming down towards Georgetown, whatever it is, here somewhere. And we get quite well supplied. That's the third boat we've seen in less than a week. I'm not sure how long we'll stick this sailing malarkey because we'll have to get there in good light. And we've got a fair bit of manoeuvring to do after we get to the waypoint, which is only 7.5 miles away. But at 2.5 knots, that's going to take us 3 hours. And it's already just gone 12, so we'll see. We were doing over 3 knots a minute ago, which is quite nice, but it didn't last very long. So now we're arriving at this is Soldier Key here, and this is a cut that we go through. It seems to be very narrow.
Stay away from the right
hand side,
yeah. Yeah, because of the flood, there could be rocks. So we can steer more, keep more to the port side.
Yeah. Now we have to concentrate. Navigation out. I've also got a boss up the front and I'm looking from here from a slightly elevated position, which is good also. So here we go. Trying to cut. Should be alright, but what? The visibility is good. The sun is still high and we can see the bottom, so just have not to hit it. Kidok, my friend. Well, here we are. I've come to see the piggies and we're going to see them lying in the water. Up here by the point. I'll go ashore and see if we can get some better pictures. But for the meantime, we're here at White Kay Bay. We've done 278 for the month and we've done 17 and a half today. Motor sailing and sailing. We did a bit of both and a bit of motoring at the beginning before we got any wind at all. I hope it's deep enough here. It's almost exactly high tide. Oh, Mr. Piggy, you know you can come in.
Hey! Off you go!
One word from Sandra, and he's off.
Come. What if they get in here? I have to swim back to the boat. It's a far way and there's rocks here. Off you go, my friend, yes. Yeah, lovely. Good-bye, you're the weakest one. Goodbye. Goodbye, Mr. Piggy.
Are you nervous, Miss Sandra?
I just don't. They're a little bit too close for me. A little bit too close.
These are little baby piggies.
Yeah, come, let's go.
Oh, it's a chicken.
Chicken, flying chickens, seagulls, big angry pigs. First time in my life. And then, you want us to get up there and get crazy? Off of and into the boat.
Two little baby ones.
Is it little baby pigs or their dogs? Piggies.
Baby piglets.
Piglets. My goodness gracious me, they were very excited to see us, but I was not.
You're such a wuss. is a pad, sort of almost finished. And it's not in a bad spot at all. Not in a bad spot at all. The view is better than average, I guess. The Cabana Beach Bar is almost right next door. What more can you want? Okay, after a very pleasant stop here in White Bay Cay, which we had to ourselves. I'm not going to be tourists in the local area here, I think. Land with the pigs, feeding the pigs and so on. That must be cue for us to move along. Not much to Rollville, but that was a nice little stop. Nice little bar down there, cabana down there. And the boss is on the anchor. Time to go. There's our next door neighbour from last night. Still here. It's a really nice spot. The water is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Well, Commodore, what's occurring?
Oh, we arrived at Farmers Cay, and it's stunning, beautiful. Another beautiful island, isolated from nowhere. Just quiet, peaceful, and not many people, but...
No, we're not on our own, though. There's this big catamaran we're seeing when we arrived, and this other lagoon was just arriving at the same time as us. So there's the three of us now. The water is reasonably deep and I'm about to go for a swim. We have to be a little bit careful. There are lots of little jellyfish, which you probably can't see, but they seem to come in swarms. And we were told when we checked in at Great Niagara, it's the season, end of April, beginning of May is the season for these little buggers, and they sting like the devil, apparently. And you really don't want to get stung by them. So, I've been designated by the boss to check it out. There's one there on its own. There's a couple more, in fact there's half a dozen over there. And if I don't get stung too badly, then the Commodore's going to go in. So, here we are. Farmer's Cut. The numbers for today don't make a lot of difference. We've done 304 for the month and 26 for the day. We motored pretty much the whole way. We did attempt to sail some of the way, but it wasn't very successful. But the lack of wind, and with us having the jenny out, did allow Sandra and I to do some repair work on the jenny, which was needing to be done. So we did that, and I got myself a little bit crisp in the sun doing it, but there we go. Here we have a whole bunch of little buggers coming under the hull, coming down on the current, swimming away. When we saw them in Great Niagara, we thought they were little drops of oil or something. We didn't see them quite as close as this, and it was a bit darker as well when we arrived. Maybe I won't get in the water. Okay, so it's Monday morning. Yes.
2024.
Sadly, it's time to move on
from
our brief visit to Farmer's Cut, Farmer's Cay. We didn't even go ashore, unfortunately. We got here a bit late last night, and we were going to swim, but there was loads of the baby jellyfish in the water, so we didn't. We swam this morning. It was lovely, a lot of current, but we were using the buoy to keep us safe. Now it's time to move on. Bye bye Farmer's Cay. Beautiful water here, absolutely beautiful. bye for now. Well, here we're coming to Black Point. The town itself is around the end of the point and further to the right. And we'll jibe the jetty to go around the point and head along the coast.
Well, here we are in Black Point. I see how the yachts are here at the moment. There's a lot of local skiffs. This restaurant here in front of us, the yellow one, is Lorraine's, and then next to it is the Black Point Yacht Club. So, we need to go ashore and explore.
$14, yeah, there were 15 for the month, and we did 11, 10 and a half, 11 for the day. So, that is all good. Here, and it looks like we're about to get soaked. I hope it's not going to get too windy. I'm not quite sure how secure the anchor is. We'll give it a good chuck, it seems fine, but the ground looks a little on the hard side, which worries me slightly. But anyway, we're here in Staniel Cay, and unfortunately I don't think we're going to do very much because, as I say, it looks like we're about to get soaked. Numbers we've got, we've done 324.7, call it 325 for the month, and we've done just 10 for the day, more or less. And we sailed it all pretty much, apart from this last bit in here from the point out there. We sailed all the way up from Black Point down there, and the rain is just arriving. Time to batten down the hatches. Bye for now.
Today, the 22nd of May. Yes, and we had a beautiful, peaceful sleep here at Staniel Cay. And now we're heading onwards, northwards, heading north to Nassau. Come through this narrow little passage here. Everyone's doing a good job. Many little boats or cats just tucked away where they're more protected from the wind. I think we will be able to sail today because I think the wind is going to be a bit favourable, which is great. You can save some gasoline. We've been using a lot of gasoline in the last 2-3 days due to no wind option. So now we've got up nice and early, 7:20 a.m. in the morning, so that's nearly 8 o'clock here local time. Bahamas, and that's our passage ahead. Got the sails up, got the mainsail up, so we'll be being very optimistic. We're going to be sailing. Yeah, our mainsail's up, guys, so not so bad as on our way. Yes, so today's Wednesday. We're actually maneuvering ourselves through this little broad flat rocks. Making a bit of a noise, not happy, he's playing around with it. Stanley Kay, captain in the house.
Well, it's Wednesday and we're left to Stanley Kay. We are sailing, which is nice. There's not an awful lot of wind, maybe 10 knots. As a result, we've got the whole sail up for the first time. Okay, so here we are, parked on this beautiful little beach, all our lonesome. The beach next door isn't marked as an anchorage, but actually it looks better because it's got a bit more shelter at that point there, although we get some shelter from that as well, I guess. But anyway, this is indicated as the anchorage, although technically you can anchor anywhere in the
in the Bahamas. But anyway, we've done so, but 342 exactly, yeah, exactly 342 for the month and 17 for the day. And we sailed about just over half of that, I think, 10 miles, give or take. And then the wind gave up on us, and then when it came back, it was too from right on the nose. We're in quite deep water here, 7.5 meters below the hull, so that's 9 meters, give or take. And so we've got a lot of anchor out, a lot of chain out. We were initially quite a lot closer to the beach, but it got very shallow very quickly, and I was nervous. So the wind has been all over the shop. And over the last few days, and 1 minute it's from the east, the next minute it's from the south, and then it's from the north, then it's the west. And I didn't want us to park too close to the beach, which is the recommendation, to get in tight to the beach. But you've got to be sure of your wind then, because otherwise we could end up parked up on the beach. So here we go. Here we are. I think I should go for sort out the mainsail. We just dropped it, and we had the whole thing up. So need to tidy up the mainsail, and then I shall go and dive on the anchor and maybe have a snorkel. It's recommended snorkeling around this point here. Thank you.